Hello, my name is Keshwani. That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I, Keshwani. Today we'll have part 3 of our percentage problem series. In the first part we did problems 1 through 10. In the second part we did 11 through 20. And today is our third part, part number 3. Where we'll do number 21 through 30 of percentage problems. Let's get going, shall we? Number 21. Question is, what percent of 5 is 6? What percent of 5 is 6? And how do we get an equation out of it? Well, we have done it several times. Very simple. What is the unknown part, which we usually represent with letter X? That's just a tradition. That's just an orthodox way of doing it, traditional way of doing it, classical way. Usually we use letter X. Percent means over 100. Of means times. 5 is means equals. And 6. There we go. One more time, I'm going to remind you, do not get confused with the multiplication sign and the letter X. In multiplication sign, I lift my hand. In letter X, I do not lift my hand. So that's it. We have to get the X by itself. Why don't we divide top and bottom by 5 first? So 5 goes away and 100 is going to become 20. So it's X over 20 is what we have on this side, which equals 6. If you multiply both sides by 20, something is going drastically wrong. What percent of 5 is 6? What percent of 5 is 6? Okay. So multiply. So we have x over 20. X over 20 is equal to 6 here. X over 20 is equal to 6. We want to get rid of this 20 from the bottom here. So multiply both sides by 20. We can get rid of the 20. And the answer is x equals 6 times 120. 6 times 20, which is 120. So now we go back to our problem where the word what appears, because what is represented by letter X. We substitute our answer that we are claiming. We are claiming that the answer is 120. And we'll see if it makes any sense. So the claim that we are making here is that 120% of 5 is 6. Does it make any sense to you to claim, to go around saying to people that 120% of 5 is 6? Let's find out, shall we? We know 100% of 5. How much is 100% of 5? Well, that's just a silly question. 100% of 5 is just 5. And we also know that 20% of anything is a fifth. A fifth of anything is 20%. So 20% of 5 is a fifth of 5. A fifth of 5 is 1. So if 20% of 5 is 1 and 100% of 5 is 5, then it stands to reason that 100 plus a 20, 120% of 5 should equal 6, which is exactly what we're claiming. We're claiming that 6 is 120% of 5. 120% of 5, we're claiming right here, 120% of 5. See right here, the equation is right here. This is the exact same equation. 120% of 5 is 6. Voila. 120% of 5 is 6. Question was, what percent of 5 is 6? The answer is 120. Let's do number 22, shall we? Number 22. Seventy-five percent of 44, we are told, is same as 30% of what? Again, you're going to get the equation out of it. 75%, which is 75 over 100, 75% means over 100, of means times, 44 is same as, that's your equal sign. Then we have 30% means over 100, of means times, and this is our unknown. We have 100 at the bottom here, we have 100 at the bottom here. Let's multiply both sides of the equation. Let's multiply both sides of the equation by 100. If you multiply this side of the equation by 100, and if you multiply this side of the equation by 100, as you can see, this 100 is going to cancel out with that 100, and this 100 is going to cancel out with that 100. What I'm going to do now, is, we're going to do the same step. We're going to do the same, exact same step that we just did a second ago, but we're not going to do it in a baby way. Do you understand? We're not babies. So let's do it as a grown-up person. Instead of showing the baby step, we just have to realize that since 100 appears here at the bottom and 100 appears here at the bottom, whatever this quantity is, we're taking a hundredth of it. Whatever this quantity is, we're taking a hundredth of this. So if the hundredth of this quantity is equal to the hundredth of that quantity, then this quantity, 75 times 44, must equal 30 times x. It goes away. We want the x by itself, so we have 30x equals this quantity. We want x by itself. Let's divide both sides by 30. If you divide both sides by 30, this 30 is going to drop out and 30 is going to appear here. So let's rewrite, shall we? So here we have x by itself. So x equals to 75 over times 44 over 30. Now it's up to you how you go about simplifying it, how you go about reducing it, whether you do it in a baby step, dividing by smallest prime number that you can find, or whether you can find some bigger factors which are not primes. For example, we could divide top and bottom by 2. There is nothing wrong with it. We can divide top and bottom by 2, or we can divide top and bottom by 5, or we can even divide top and bottom by 15. 15 is the largest common factor that I can see. 75 is a multiple of 15, 30 is a multiple of 15. But if you didn't see the 15, but you are able to see 5, let's divide top and bottom by 5. And if you didn't see 5, you can at least see 2. This is an even number, this is an even number. So the bigger common factor that you can find between the numerator and denominator, the faster your work will go, the fewer steps you will have to do. Let's divide top and bottom by 5. We will not divide by 15, we will not divide by 2, we'll take the happy medium. Let's divide top and bottom by 5. 6 5s are 30, 30 has 6 5s. How many 5s does 75 have? What the hell do I know? Let's find out, shall we? Well, I know 7 has 1 5. 7 has 1 5. That I do know. Once we take away 5 from the 7, we have a remainder of 2. That 2 goes and joins to 5 and becomes 25. And 25, I know, has 5 5s. Again, I see a 15, I see a 6, I see a multiple of 15 is a multiple of 3, 6 is a multiple of 3. Let's divide top and bottom by 3. If we divide 6 by 3, it's going to become 2. And 15 has 5 3. 5 3s are 15. Now we see a 2, we see a 44, let's divide top and bottom by 2, and 44 is going to become 22, and what we end up is 5 times 22. We know that 10 times 22, we know 10 times 22 would have been 220. If 10 20s are 220, then if 10 22s rather, if 10 22s are 220, then 5 22s should be 110. And that's our answer, that's what we're claiming. We're going to put it back in here, and we're going to see if it makes sense or not. We're going to see if it makes sense or not. So what we're claiming is that 75% of 44 is same as 30% of 110. Let's find out whether or not that claim is valid, shall we? We need the room, so I'm going to erase everything here. We're going to verify it. 75% of 44. 75% of something is same as 3 quarter. 3 quarter. 3 quarter is 75%. Of means times 44. What's 3 quarter of 44? That's very simple. That's very simple because we know quarter of 44 is 11. Because 11 times 4 is 44. Quarter of 4 is 44. Therefore, 3 quarters should be 33. As you can clearly see here, if you divide top and bottom by 4, we end up with 11 times 3, we end up with 33 on this side. And what we are claiming is that this quantity here is same as this quantity here. 30% of 110. We know 10% of 110 is 11. If 10% of 110 is 11, I did not leave myself much room. I'm going to rewrite it here. If 10% of 111 we know is 11, that we do know, if 10% If 10% of something is 11, then 30% should be 3 times as much. 30% should be 3 times as much. 11 times 3 is 33. It turns out that it is indeed true. It turns out that it is indeed true that 3 quarters of 44 is same as 30% of 110. Let's do next one, shall we? Number 23. Number 23. Number 23 is asking us 40% of 30% of what is 36? 40% of 30% of what is 36? First thing we have to do is make sure we get the right equation out of it, and that's very simple, very straightforward. Never try to get the entire equation in one shot, which is what most people do, and of course in most cases, they end up mucking it up. Mucking it up. M. Not an F. M-U-C-K. Not an F, as I said. Don't get excited. They end up mucking it up. So don't try to make an entire equation. Don't try to get an entire equation. Don't try to extract the entire equation in one shot. That's not how one solves an algebraic problem. Do it one word at a time, as we have always done. 40. Percent means over 100. Let's see how it's translating it. One word at a time. Of means times. Then we have 30. Percent means over 100. Of means times. This is our unknown. X is means equals 36. There we go. This equation, we are 100% sure that it is correct. 100% sure it is correct. Now we have to get the x by itself. We have to separate the x by itself. So let's do that. You multiply both sides by 100, I'm not going to show all these steps. If you multiply both sides by 100, you're going to get it to 1/100. If you multiply both sides by 100 again, in other words, these two hundreds are going to end up on the top. You're going to cross multiply. And x is going to equal 36 over 100 times 100 over 40 times 30. We just have to simplify it. We just have to simplify it and we'll have our answer. Let's get going, shall we? I see 40 here, I see 100 here. Let's divide top and bottom by 10. If we divide top and bottom by 10, we can knock out 10 from here, 10 from there. Again, I see a 30 here, I see a 10 here. Let's divide top and bottom by 10 one more time. We can knock out one more zero. You don't have to go in this sequence, you understand? You can do it any way you like, any which way you want, as long as your arithmetic is correct. I see a 4 here, I see a 100 here. I know 100 is made up of 25 fours. 25 fours are 100. This is what we are saying. 25 fours are 100. 25 fours are 100. That's what we are saying. Which is same as saying 4 25s are 100. That is also true. 4 25s. If I have 1 25, or 1 quarter, 2 quarters, 3 quarters, 4 quarters, if I have 4 25s, that's 100 cents. Or you can say 25 fours are 100. Here we're counting by fours, we're trying to figure out how many fours 100 is, because we have a 4 at the bottom. We're going to divide top and bottom by 4. 4 is going to go away, and 100 has 25 fours. What else is left? Oh, I see a 3 here, I see a 36 here. Let's divide top and bottom by 3. 3 is going to go away, and 3 has 1 3, and 6 has 2 3s. Voila. 12 times 25. 12 times 25 is the answer. How much is 12 times 25? I know 4 times 25 is 100. 4 25s are 100. 4 25s are 100. 8 25s are 200. And 12 25s will make 300. If I have 12 quarters, I have $3. 12 quarters make $3. 4 quarters make $1. 8 quarters make $2. Therefore, 12 quarters will make $3, 300 cents. 12 times 25 is 300. That's what we are claiming. Now we go back in our problem here. Replace the word what with what we are claiming it to be. And see if it makes any sense. And see if it makes any sense. Again, I need the room, I need a lot of room, so we're gonna have to erase all of that. Just give me a second. Well, let's get going. We're done with all of this. Let's begin with this part. 30% of 300. We know 10% of 300. We know 10% of 300 is 30. That we do know. If 10% of 300 is 30, then 30% must be 3 times as much, or 90. So that part is done. 30% of 300 is 90. This part is done. This part is 90. Now we have to get a 40% of 30% of 300. We already figured out what 30% of 300 is. 30% of 300 is 90. Now we have to take a 40% of that quantity. So let's find out. We know 10%. 10% of 90, we know, is 9. Well, if 10% is 9, then 40% must be 4 times as much, or 36. Oh, there you go. By golly, what do you know? By golly, it turns out that our answer is correct. It turns out that it is indeed true. It turns out that it is indeed true that 30% of 300, if you take it, whatever that is, and then you take a 40% of that amount, what we end up is 36. In other words, it is true that 40% of 30% of 300 is 36. We just found it. Let's do one more, shall we? Next one, number 24. I didn't mean one more, I meant next one. Number 24. What is 2.5% of 1160? What is 2.5% of 1160? Again, we can solve it with an equation, in a geeky way, in a nerdy way, in a classical way, in an orthodox way, in a traditional way, in an academic way, in a freakish way, or we can do it intuitively. Let's do more straightforward, intuitive, logical way first, okay? We're looking for 2.5%. Don't worry about 2.5% right now. Let's first understand that 10% of... I left no room for myself, did I? Well, let's write the answer here, since it's going to be annoying to put an answer here, because we are used to writing it this way, you see? We know 10% of 1160. How much is 10% of 1160? But 10% of 1160 is just going to be 116. You just drop the zero. It's going to be 116. You with me? If 10% of 1160 is 116, then it stands to reason that 5%, if you divide that by 2, must be half of that quantity. Makes sense to you, doesn't it? Let's find out what that is, shall we? Let's find out what is 116 divided by 2. How many twos does one have? One has no twos. One has no twos. That one goes and joins the one. Next, that one goes and joins the one from his neighbor, and it becomes 11. How many twos does 11 have? 11 has 5 twos. 11 has 5 twos. 5 twos are 10. 5 twos are 10. 5 twos are 10. That's how we speak. Once we take away 10 from 11, we are left with remainder of 1. That one goes and joins the 6. That one goes and joins the 6 and becomes 16. And 16 has 8 twos. And that 2 goes away, because we just divided top and bottom by 2. Which makes perfect sense if you think about it, because what we had was 116. I know 100 has 50 twos. 50 twos are 100. If I have 50 twos, that's 100. We don't have 100, we have 116. 100 is made up of 50 twos and 16 is made up of 8 twos. Therefore, 116 must be 58. So that part is done. Enough of the talk. That part is done. So we have figured out that 5% of 1160 is 58. Let's put that down here, 5%. Okay, and let's put 58 over here. Well, we're not interested in 5%, we want 2.5%. But 2.5% is just half of that. 2.5% is half of that. Let me take half of this quantity. Half of five is 2.5. It's half of that quantity is what we're looking for. How many 2's does 58 have? Well, how the hell do I know this by now, shall we? I know five has 2 2's. 2 2's are 4. Once you take away 4 from the 5, we have a remainder of 1. That 1 goes and joins the 8 and becomes 18. And 18 has 9 2's. Voila. Which makes perfect sense if you think about it. I did not know how many 2's 58 had, but I did know that 60 is made up of 30 2's. 30 times 2 is 60. And since 60 is only 2 more than 58, or since 58 is only 1 2 less than 60, since 60 has 30 2's, it stands to reason that 58 should have 29 2's. Let's put it back in here. This is what we're claiming. 29 is 2.5% of 1160. As a matter of fact, as soon as I put it here, I realized that this part that we just did here is typically what we would have done in our verification part. First we solve the problem in the traditional way with the algebra, and then once we have the answer, we ask ourselves, does this answer make any sense at an intuitive level, at a gut level? And at that point, we show this work. So this, in fact, was the verification. So now we actually have to find the answer. In other words, now we have to solve the problem algebraically. So let's solve it. Sure. The answer is, what is 2.5% of 1160? And we're going to find that the answer is going to turn out to be 29. And we know 29 makes sense because we just showed it here. So let's do it. Let's do it algebraically. The geeky way, the nerdy way, the classical way, the orthodox way, the freakish way. You understand? The way your math teacher will expect you to solve. You understand? The academic way. What? That's our unknown. X is means equals. 2.5% means over 100. Of means times. 1160. Are you with me? Okay, watch what happens. I don't like this business of 2.5 over 100. I don't like that business. So you know what we're going to do? We're going to take this 2.5 over 100. We're going to take this quantity, which I should have written this in the same way where it lines up. 2.5 over 100. I don't like this business of 2.5 over 100. Since I don't have the room, I'm going to do it right here. What I'm about to say, this is what we have. X equals this, right? And we're going to take this quantity, 2.5 over 100, we're going to multiply the top and the bottom by 10. Watch what happens. If we multiply top and bottom by 10, we haven't changed anything, because 10 over 10 is just 1. We haven't changed anything. How much is 10 times 2.5? 10 times 2 is 20, and 10 halves are 5. 10 halves are 5. 10 halves are 5. 2 halves are 1. 4 halves are 2, 6 halves are 3. Do you understand? 10 halves are 5. So 10 times 2, 10 times 2.5, 10 times 2 is 20, and 10 halves are 5. Which makes perfect sense, of course, because 2.5 is same as 2.5. And of course, we know 2.5 times 10 is 25. So now we have a whole number. We don't have to deal with this mumbo jumbo of 2.5. So it's 25 on the top, and at the bottom we have 10 times 100. 10 times 100. And don't forget, here we have 1160. But as you can clearly see, that this is turning into a freak show. This is turning into a veritable freak show. Don't do it this way. If you can find a quicker way, if you can find an intuitive way, if you can figure out how to solve the problem at a gut level, then go with it. Don't have to do it in a nerdy, geeky, freakish way every single time. It's a waste of time. This is a sheer waste of time. It's not necessary. I'm just doing it just to show you what we would do if we had to do it. But in the real exam, whether you're preparing for GRE or GMAT or SAT or ACT or TEES or HESI, in any of these real exams, you don't have to do the work. You don't have to show the work because nobody looks at your work. I see 25 at the top, I see 100 at the bottom. Why don't we divide top and bottom by 25? Let's do that. 25 is gone and 100 is going to become 4. With me? I see 10 at the bottom and I see 1160 at the top, why don't we divide top and bottom by 10? Divide top and bottom by 10, 10 is going to go away and 0 is going to drop out. Now we have to divide 116 by 4. So what we are left with is 116 divided by 4. Right, let's put it here. 116 divided by 4. I could have continued here. Let me continue here. It's not necessary to do it here. Let's continue here. We're going to divide top and bottom by 4. We're going to cancel out this 4. We're going to divide this by 4. How do we know? How do we know that this number is divisible by 4? Because the last two digits of the number are divisible by 4. As long as the last two digits of a number is divisible by 4, the number itself is divisible by 4. Something that we learned long time ago in our basic math series. In our basic math series, I don't have the schedule in front of me, so I cannot tell you which day we learned, but we learned the divisibility rule. Just type in divisibility rules along with my name, Keshwani, and search for it. It will pop right up. Just type in divisibility rules, Keshwani. Anytime you're looking for any topic, just type in the name of the topic along with my name, it will pop right up. And we learn in those divisibility rules videos that if the last two digits of a number are divisible by 4, then the number itself is divisible by 4. And since 16 is divisible by 4, 116 is divisible by 4. Let's divide it, shall we? This 4 is going to go away because we're going to divide by 4. How many 4s does 1 have? 1 has no 4. 1 has no 4. That one goes and joins the other one, becomes 11. And 11 has 2 4s. 11 has 2 4s. 2 4s are 8. After we take away 8 from the 11, we are left with 3. We are left with the remainder of 3. That 3 goes and joins the 6 and becomes 36. And 36 has 9 4s. The 4 goes away. 9 4s. And the answer is 29. And had we done it that way, we would have arrived at the answer of 29. And then the question is that answer actually correct? Is our claim valid? We are claiming that 29 is 2.5% of 1,160. And of course, we already showed the work earlier that it is indeed correct. It does indeed make sense because 10% of 1,160 will be 116. Therefore, 5% would be half of 116. Half of 100 is 50, and half of 16 is 8. Therefore, half of 116 is 58, which will represent 5%. And therefore, 2.5% would be half of 58, half of 50 is 25, and half of 8 is 4, 25 plus 4 is 29. Voila. Let's do the next one, shall we? Number 25. Number 25. Number 25 says 27 is 15% of 20%. I should write it in one line, that way we can have our equation nicely come out. 27 is 15% of 20% of what? It's always a good idea to write the whole thing in one line. That way we can work on our equation nicely, word by word. 27 is means equal, 15% means over 100, of means times, 20% means 100, percent means over 100, of means times, and this is our unknown mod. Voila. We want the x by itself. We have to separate the x by itself. We're going to divide both sides by 100 times 100. If we multiply both, if we multiply both sides of the equation by 100, by 100 times 100, these 200s are going to drop out from here and they're going to appear on the top here. So x equals 27 times 100 times 100. And if we divide both sides of the equation by 15 times 20, then then this 15 times 20 is going to cancel out this 15 times 20 and they're going to appear here. See, that's why I don't like to do it here, because now my teacher from my school years would not like this. This is, does not look pretty. This equal sign has to be brought down. So 15 times 20. One. Let's pick up speed. Again, you see same thing here. One. What do you see here? I see 20 and I see 100. Let's divide top and bottom by 20. 20 goes away and 100 has 5 20s. I see 100 and I see 15. Let's divide top and bottom by 5. If we divide top and bottom by 5, 15 has 3 5s and 100 has 20 5s. I see 27 and I see 3. Let's divide top and bottom by 3. 3 is going to go away and 27 has 9 3s are 27. This is a mess. Well, actually, it's not a mess. This is just 100. This is just 100. 20 times 5 is 100. 100 times 9. 100 times 9 is just going to be 900. That's what we are claiming. We are claiming that the answer is 900. So we go back in here, our problem, and we substitute the value that we are claiming, 900. And now we have to show, that this answer is indeed valid, that this answer is indeed correct, that this answer does indeed make sense. Let's find out, shall we? Let's show it. We need room as always, so we're going to have to erase stuff. I'm going to erase everything actually. So let's start with 27 is 15% of 20% of 900. Let's start with what is 20% of 900. We know 10% of 900 is 90. That we do know. 10% of 900 is 90. Therefore, 20% must be twice as much. That was the easy part. 180. So we have taken care of this part. 20% of 900 is 180. We just found out. So this part, this entire part is 180. Now we have to take a 15% of it. We have to take a 15% of it and show that 15% of this quantity is 27. We know 10% of 180 is 18. Well, if 10% of 180 is 18, then that implies that it must be true that 5% of 180 If 10% of 180 is 18, then 5% must be 9. And therefore, 15% of 180 must equal 18 plus 9, which is indeed 27. 27 is indeed 15% of 180, which in turn is 20% of 900. In other words, 27 is indeed 15% of 20% of 900. The answer is correct. Let's do the next one, shall we? We are halfway done. 5 down, 5 more to go. The last five percentage problems that we'll do in this series of percentage problems are going to be a little bit different. Are going to be different kind of animals. We're going to play a little game. Here's the game. The game is, I'm going to give you two quantities, in column A and in column B. And your job is simply to tell me which quantity is bigger. Is the quantity in column A bigger? If the quantity in column A is bigger, the answer is going to be A. If the quantity in column B is bigger, you're going to tell me that the answer is B. If you feel that these two quantities are equal, then the answer is going to be C. That's all it is. You're going to have to figure out the value of the two quantities in the two columns. Simply tell me which quantity is bigger. Or if they're equal, here we go. 40% of 250, this is number 26, A. Number 26, A. 40% of 250 versus 20% of 500. 20% of 500. Oh, what is 40% of 250? We know 10% of 250 is 25. That we do know. 10% of 250 is 25. If 10% is 25, then 40% must be 4 times as much. Turns out that quantity on this side is 100.
What about that side?
We know 10% of 500 is 50. If 10% is 500, 10% of 500 is 50, then 20% must be twice as much. 20 times 2 times 50 is 100 also. These two are equal.
The question is, the million-dollar question is, were you able to see right away, just by looking at these two quantities, were you able to see right away, immediately, without having done any work at all, that these two quantities are indeed equal? We didn't have to do any work at all. These two quantities have to be equal to each other. Why? Why do they have to be equal to each other? For one very simple reason.
The reason is, here we have 40%, here we have 20%. We have half the percentage, instead of 40%, we have 20%. But twice the amount, instead of 250, we have 500.
So if you double the amount and take half the percentage of the original percentage, original was 40%, instead of 40%, if you take only 20% of the amount, but the amount itself is twice as much as the original amount, then of course they're going to be equal. Let's do one more, shall we?
Let's do one more. 26B. 26B. Actually, 26B is going to be right here. Here's the other part.
This part is the same as before. 40% of 250. 40% of 250 versus 80% of 125. 80% of 125. How would you find 80% of 125? If we actually had to find it, if we actually had to calculate 80% of 125, how would we do it? Very simple.
80% means 80 over 100 times 125. Divide top and bottom by 25. 125 is 525. 100 has 425. Divide top and bottom by 4. And 80 has 24. 20 times 5 is 100, which is the same as this quantity.
On the way, we could figure out 80% of 125 is to simply realize that 80% of any quantity is simply 4/5. 4/5 is 80%. 80% is 4/5. 4/5 of 125. Divide top and bottom by 5. How many 5 does 1 have? 1 has no 5. 1 has no 5. That 1 goes and joins the 2 and becomes 12. How many 5 does 12 have? 12 has 2 5s. 2 5s are 10. After we take away 10 from the 12, we are left with remainder of 2. That 2 goes and joins the 5s and becomes 25. Voila. Very good. And we end up with 4 times 25, which is 100. This is only in the event that you actually have to calculate in the exam. But here, of course, you don't have to do that. Here, we don't have to do any calculation. We simply have to realize that here we have 40% and here we have 80%. It is twice the percentage. Before we had half the percentage, here we have twice the percentage. Instead of 40%, we have 80%, but only half the amount. Instead of 125, instead of 250, we have 125. Half the amount. Twice the percentage, but half the amount. Of course, they're going to be equal to each other, because they negate each other. They negate each other. Again, if you would excuse me, in the event, I know it's a very simple word. I know it's a very simple word. But since it did crop up,
negate. And I'll tell you why I'm making a fuss about it. We learned this word in our vocabulary lesson on day 85.
On day 85, negate. Just type in vocabulary words, day 85, and you will learn this word. The reason we are making a fuss about it is because I want to find out, I want to learn what the noun of the word is. Negate is a verb. What's the noun? The noun of negate is negation. Do you understand? Like add, addition, subtract, subtraction, negate, negation. That's it. They negate each other. That's what they undo each other. Number 27.
I'm going to pick up speed now.
I'm going at too much of a leisurely pace. I don't know why.
Number 27. 30% of 700 versus
15% of 1400. But of course, once you understand the trick, there is not much in here to do. There is not much here at all. But if you had to do it, we can very quickly figure out 10% of 100, 10% 10% of 1400 is 140. 10% is 140. If 10% of 1400 is 140, then 5% another this is 10%. This is 10%. Another 5% would be half the amount, which is 70. On this side, we have 140 plus 70. Let's see what we have here. Here, 30% is same as 3/10 of 700. Divide top and bottom by 10. Zeros are going to cancel out, and we end up with 3 times 70, which is exactly what we have here. 2 times 70 plus 1 times 70, we have 3 times 70. These two quantities are equal. Of course they are equal. Of course, we knew it. We knew it all along. We knew it from the very beginning that they are equal to each other, because, again, we have half the percentage. Instead of 30%, we have 15%. We have half the percentage, but twice the amount, 1400 as opposed to 700. So they negate each other. They nullify each other. They undo each other. Let's do the next one. How about 30% of 700 versus 60% of 350? Again, instead of 30%, we have 60%. We have twice the percentage, but half the amount. Instead of 700, we have 350. We have twice the percentage, but half the amount. Of course, they're going to equal each other, because they're going to negate each other. What we're going to do right now is, if we were taking the real exam, and if we had to very quickly figure out what is 60% of 350, we'd be able to do it very quickly. Let's find out, shall we? This one, we already know the answer. We did it a little while ago. It was 3 times 70. Let's see what we get here. Of course, we're going to get 3 times 70. We're going to get 210. But let's pretend that we didn't know that. If we had to do it out, how would we do it? Very simple. 60% of anything is just 3/5. 3/5 of 350. Let's divide top and bottom by 5. 5 goes away, and 35 has 7 fives, and 0 has no fives. 70 times 3 is exactly what we have here. They're equal to each other. Let's do the next one, shall we? 28. 28. I'm getting a little tired and a little hungry. 40% of 600 versus 80% of 300. But you get the idea now. You're beginning to see the idea. But if we had to do it out, if we had to calculate it, how would we calculate it? You can do it any way you want. 40%, we know 10% of 600 is 60. If 10% of 600 is 60, 40% would be 4 times as much, which is 240. Let's put it here on this side, 240, so that we have room to work here. And what do you suppose we're going to get here? 80% of 300. 80% we know is 4/5. 4/5 of any quantity is 80%, because 1/5 is 20%, 2/5 is 40%, 3/5 is 60%, 4/5 is 80%. Well, we go in the increment of 20 percentages. 4/5 or 80% of 300. Divide top and bottom by 5. 5 is going to go away. 30 has 6 5. 6 5 is 30. 0 has no 5. So it's 60 times 4. 60 times 4 is 240. Which, of course, we knew right all along. We knew all along that these two quantities are going to be equal to each other. Because here we have twice the percentage. Instead of 40%, we have 80%. Instead of 40%, we have 80%. But half the amount. Instead of 600, we have 300. So we're taking twice the percentage of half the amount. They're going to negate each other. Let's do one more, shall we? How about 40% of 600 versus Well, you get the idea now. Can you guess what I'm about to write? Versus 20% of, 20% of what? See, instead of 40%, we're taking half the percentages. If you're taking half the percentages, we have to undo it. We have to negate that, the fact that we just cut the percentage in half. So we have to take twice the amount of 1200. Of course they're going to be equal to each other. Of course they're going to be equal to each other. Now let's just pretend that we didn't know this, we didn't have this quantity, and we have to figure out this part. It's very simple. 10% is 120, 10% of this quantity is 120, 20% is going to be twice as much. 120 times 2 is 240, which we found out earlier was the case here. What's the case here? Let's do one more. Number 29. Percent of 450 versus 50% of 250 versus 50% of 250. Are they equal to each other? You think so? Let's find out. 50% of 250. What is 50% of 250? That's half of 250. Half of 250. What is half of 250? Half of 250 is, half of 200 is 100, and half of 50 is 25. Half of 250 is 125. What do you suppose we get here? 1/4, 25% is 1/4. 1/4 of 450. 1/4 of 450. How do we divide it? Let's divide top and bottom by 4, shall we? And of course, we will not be able to divide evenly by 4 because 50, last two digits of 450
are 5 and 0, 50.
And 50 is not divisible by 4, so if you were to divide top and bottom by 4, it will not be evenly divisible. It will not be evenly divisible by 4. That in itself is your cue that something has gone wrong drastically. This is not going to be a whole number. Here we have a whole number, 125. Something has gone wrong. Something has gone wrong. Let's find out, shall we?
How many 4's does 4 have? 4 has 1 4. How many 4's does 5 has? 5 has 1 4.
After we take away 4 from the 5, we have a remainder of 1. That 1 goes and joins the 0, becomes 10, and 10 has 2 4's. 10 has 2 4's. 2 4's are 8. After we take away 8 from the 10, we have a remainder of 2. We have a remainder of 2 that needs to be divided by 4. This quantity is 112 and 2 4's. 2 4's is same as 1 quarter. Or rather, 2/4 is the same as 1/2. These two quantities are not equal. 125 is bigger than 112.5. What went wrong? This is not correct. This is not correct. What went wrong? Can you spot what went wrong here? Can you figure out what went wrong?
What went wrong here is the fact that we have twice the percentages, but not half the amount. It is 250. This quantity is not half of 450. Half of 450 is 225. It was not 225. This quantity is 250.
Had it been 225, then these two would have been equal. It was not 225, it was 250. Let's do one more. Last one. Number 30.
How about 25% of 750 versus 12.5% of 1500? See, here we have 25%. Here we have 12.5%. 12.5% is exactly half of 25. We are taking half the percentage. Is this amount twice of this amount? If the answer is yes, then these two quantities are equal. And the answer is indeed yes. 1500 is exactly 2 times 750.
Had it been 1400, then this quantity would have been less than this quantity. But because
12.5% of anything, listen carefully, okay? Listen carefully. 12.5% of anything less than 1500, 12.5% of anything less than 1500 would have been less than 25% of 750. But because we have 1500, which is exactly 2 times 750, 1500 is exactly twice of 750, since we have twice the amount and half the percentages, these two quantities are indeed equal. We don't have to do it out. Understand? That was it. That was it. I do not know what the next topic is going to be, but there are several topics I want to cover. I want to cover all the major topics that one encounters when one is preparing for GRE or GMAT or TEs or HESIs or SAT or SAT. There are standard topics that appear in all of these exams, all of these tests, such as percentages, ratio and proportion, linear equations, several other topics that are not coming to my mind, things having to do with geometry, and I'm going to cover them topic by topic, and we're going to make a series of 10 or 20 or 30 videos, or however long it takes for me to cover the topic, and we're going to master all of those topics so that we are ready for the exam, whichever exam that you're preparing for. It doesn't matter, because these topics appear in all of these tests, whether you're preparing for GRE or GMAT or SAT or SAT or SE or TEs, HESI or TEs or SAT or SAT or GRE or GMAT, they appear everywhere. So I don't know what the next topic is going to be, but I'm sure I'm going to come up with something, and we're going to keep doing that. We're going to cover topic by topic until we have covered all the major topics that appear in these exams. Do you understand? Why not?